Hello students, today we will start a new chapter, chapter number 7 from part 2 and chapter name is limits, okay. So first of all, in this chapter we are going to see the limits of function. So you will have one function f of x, okay, in terms of x, and you need to find out the limit of that function whenever your variable x will approach to some value a. Okay, so suppose x is a variable and a is a constant, and x is taking the value which is closer to a but not exactly equals to a. Okay, I'll show you how. Suppose your a is equals to 2, okay, because a will be constant and x we are taking as a variable. So suppose this is 1, 2, 3, minus 1 and minus 2. This is number line. So we are taking a as equals to 2, right? Now what we have to do, we have to choose the values which are closer to the a. So we can take this as 2.1, right? 2.2, 2.3. So these values must be lie on this side, right? That means it will be greater than 2. And there is another option for choosing the values of a, that will be 1.9 1.8, and that values will be lies below 2, right? So you have two options, two side options to take the values of a. Either you can take values which are greater than 2 or you can take which are less than 2. Okay, so here we are taking values for x which are closer to a but not exactly equal to a. Okay, and then for that values we will find out the value of the function. So that value will be considered as a limit of that function. Okay, so here this notation is called as x is tends to a. So whenever your x will approach to a, or you can say x is tends to a, your function will be tends to some value. That value will be considered as a limit whenever your x is approaches to a. Okay, now for this we have two symbols. As we have seen, x will take either greater value or less than value of a. So that will be denoted by like this, x is tends to a minus. Okay, so a minus is just a symbol and a plus. So whenever you have a symbol like this, x is approaches to a minus, that means you have to consider the lower value. Okay, so it is called x is tends to a smaller values, and whenever you have this symbol, x is approaches to a plus, that means x is taking the value which are greater than a. Okay, so here x will take all the values which are less than a, and here it will take all the values which are greater than a. Now we'll take one example of a function f of x which is equal to 3, okay, and we will take the value of x very close to 3. Okay, so we have to take x which is approaches to 3. That means we have to take the values which are closer and closer to 3 but not exactly equals to 3. For that we will make two columns, two tables for the lower values and upper values. So these are the values of x, values of f of x. So here 3 plus, that means all the values which are greater than 3, right? And here all the values which are less than 3. So we'll take some possible values. Okay, so what will be the possibilities of the values which are less than 3? You can take 2.99, 2.8, right? That are less than 3. And for greater than 3, you can take 3.1, 3.2 like that. So here I'll start with 2.5, 2.6, continue 2.9, 2.99. Okay? Clearly you can see that 2.99 is greater than 2.9. So for this, how to find out the value of the function? Whenever your x is tending to value 2.5, your function will become 2.5 plus 3, right? You have to substitute 2.5 in this function. So you will get 2.5 plus 3, that is 5.5. So the value of the function is, and note that this also not equals to 5.5. This is also tends to 5.5 because we are taking the closer value. We are not taking exact value, okay? So here you will get 5.5. If you substitute 2.6 into this function, then you will get 5.6. If you substitute 2.9, the answer for the function will be 5.9. And for 2.99, it is 5.99. Okay? Then, for the positive values, we will take 3.6. 3. You have 3 here, okay? So here we have taken 2.99, and for the greater than value, we have to take 3.01, 3.1, 3.2, like that, okay? So, in textbook on page number 133, they have taken the values from right hand side, okay? So, you can take like this also. This is 3.01, 3.1 up to 3.6, okay? So, for 3.01, the value is coming 0.6.01. If you substitute 3.01 in this function, so 3.01 plus 3, that will be 6.01, okay? Similarly, the value of function at x is equals to 3.1, it is 6.1. And for 3.6, it will be 6.6, okay? So, you can see that whenever your x is tends to 3, from either side, f of x will tends to 6, okay? So, as you coming near and near to 3, that means the last value we have taken as 2.99. And here we have taken the last value as 3.01. Last means which is closer to 3. Right here we have taken the last value which is closer to 3 is 3.01. And here we have taken 2.99. Right? So, in both the cases we are getting answer 5.99 means closer to 6. And here also we are getting the answer 6.01, that is closer to 6, right? Therefore, you can say that the limiting value of the function is 6. And you can write down like this. The limiting value of the function is tends to 6 whenever your x is tends to 3, okay? So, this is about the general idea about limit. Now we will see the actual definition, the theoretical definition of the limit, and the some example based on that. So here we can see that x is approaching to 3. That means the difference between x and 3 will be very small, right? The difference should not be equals to 0. If the difference between x and 3 is equals to 0, that means we are taking the value of x is exactly equals to 3. That we are not doing that. Okay, so therefore, if you are taking x is approaching to 3, that means if you take a difference between x and 3, then it should be a very small value that we will consider as an epsilon, or you can consider as a delta in terms of mathematical symbol, okay? So, the epsilon and delta is a very smaller and real number. It is very, very small and it is near to the zero. It is not exactly equals to 0. So therefore we will see the definition of a limit. Okay, so whenever you are saying your function is tends to some limit, for x is tends to some value a, that means the difference between function and the limit must be some epsilon, that is a very smaller value, and the difference between x and a also be a smaller value, then only this will be possible. Okay, this is the actual meaning of the limit. So whenever you are saying the limit of the function f of x whenever x tends to a is equals to l, and this will be possible only if the difference between function and the limit must be less than epsilon, and the difference between x and a must be less than delta. Whenever l, epsilon and the delta are very smaller number, and there should be exist. Okay, so we will see the definition which is given on page number 134. The definition of a limit. If a given epsilon greater than 0, okay, greater than 0, but it should be very small. That means it can be a 0.000001 and like that. So if a given epsilon greater than 0, there exists, this is a sign for there exists, delta greater than 0. Okay, so for a given epsilon there exists a delta greater than 0 such that f of x minus l is less than epsilon for all x minus a less than delta. Okay, so for the given epsilon there exists a delta greater than 0 such that f of x minus l is less than epsilon for all the values x minus a less than delta, then we say f of x is tends to l whenever x is tends to a. Okay, so for this f of x tends to l whenever x tends to a, this should exist epsilon. For the given epsilon there should exist a delta which is greater than 0 such that the difference between the function, the value of the function and that limit less than epsilon, and the difference between x and a must be less than delta. Okay, then only we can say the limit of the function is l whenever x is approaches to a, and we will write this as limit of the function f of x for x tends to a is equals to l. Okay, so this is the theoretical definition of limit. Now we'll see some another definition, one sided limit, left hand limit and right hand limit. Okay, so one sided limit is a concept which is connected to this, whenever x is approaches to a plus and a minus. I have already told you what is a meaning of the symbol x is approaches to a plus and a minus. Okay, that means x will take the values which are less than a or greater than a. So these three definitions are related to that only. So first definition is one-sided limit. So one-sided limit means if limit of the function f of x for x tends to a minus, that means x is taking all the negative value, all the lesser values, smaller values of a, right? Or limit x tends to a plus of f of x. Okay, so if they exist with minus also and with plus also, then we can say that they are one-sided limit. Okay, so here if this exists and this exists, then we can say they are one-sided limit. If only this function, only this side limit is exist, limit x tends to a minus of f of x is exist, then here we will say this is left hand limit. Okay, we can say this is left hand limit, and only if this is exist, then we can say right hand limit. Left hand limit and right hand limit. Okay, so for the definition, how we will define the left hand limit? So for epsilon, for the given epsilon greater than 0, there exist delta greater than 0 such that f of x minus l is less than epsilon whenever for all x with, here we will take all the x which are less than a, and it should be greater than a minus delta. Okay, so we have to consider this definition, f of x minus l less than epsilon for all x is less than a and should be greater than a minus delta. Okay, then we can say this is left hand limit. And for the right hand limit, for the given epsilon greater than 0, there exists delta greater than 0 such that f of x minus l less than epsilon for all x with, here what we will take, x should be what? Your x should be greater than a and it should be less than a plus delta. Okay, so here the notation will be limit x tends to a minus of f of x is equals to l. Okay, and here the notation will be limit x tends to a plus of f of x, which is equals to but for the definition, you have to consider x should be less than a and it should be greater than a minus delta. And here, we will take all the values which are greater than a, right? And it should be less than a plus delta. So, this is left hand limit and this is right hand limit. Okay? Now, the next definition is existence of a limit of a function at a particular point A. Okay, so the next definition is existence of a limit of a function at a point x is equals to a. Okay, now we will see existence of a limit of a function at a point x is equals to a. Okay, so the condition for existence of a limit of any function is that if limit x tends to a plus of f of x is equals to limit x tends to a minus of f of x is equals to l. That means left hand side and right hand side limit exist and it should be equal. Then this is called, then we can say that the that function f of x has a limit. Okay, so the condition will be its left hand and right hand limit should be exist and it should be equal. Now we'll see one example. And suppose if the left hand side limit and the right hand side limit is exist but they are not equal, then we can say the function doesn't have limit. Okay, now we'll take one example. Find the left hand limit and the right hand limit for the following function, and the function is given like this: f of x is equals to 3x plus 1, 7x square minus 3 whenever x is less than 1 and x is greater than and equals to 1. We have to find the left hand limit and the right hand limit for the following function. So in this case, it doesn't mention that the value of a. That means we don't know. It is not given that x is approaches to which value. Okay. But here the range is given for x is less than 1 and x is greater than equals to 1. So we will consider a as equals to 1. Okay. So for the left hand limit means all the values which are x will approaches to all the values which are smaller than 1, right? So the left hand limit, that means limit x tends to a minus of f of x. So here we have considered the value of a as 1, and the 1 minus means it is left hand limit. So for all the values of x which are less than 1, x is less than 1, the function is defined like this, 3x plus 1. So we will consider the value of function as 3x plus 1. Okay, now you can directly put x as equals to 1 in this function. We don't have to put x as minus 1, okay? Because here the minus is just a symbol to denote we are finding left hand limit. So just put x is equals to 1, we'll get 3 into 1 plus 1, 3 plus 1, that is equals to 4. So here the left hand limit is equals to 4. Similarly, we will find out the right hand limit. Okay, so the right hand limit is denoted by x is tends to a plus of f of x. So here we are using this notation, okay, for the right hand limit. So this is equals to limit x tends to 1 plus. 1 plus means all the values of x which are greater than 1. And for the x is greater than or equals to 1, the function is defined like this, 7x square minus 3. So we'll take the value of the function as 7x square minus 3. Okay, now we will substitute value of x is equals to 1 in this function. So 1 square is 1, 7 into 1 minus 3, it is equals to 4. So we can clearly see that left hand limit and the right hand limit is equal, 4, 4. Okay, so therefore we can say that the given function has a limit which is equals to 4 whenever x is tends to a. So this is the method to find out the left hand and the right hand limit. Now we will see some algebra of a limit. Okay, like we have an algebra over the number, addition, subtraction. Similarly, we have algebra over the functions, over the limit, sorry. So, while doing limit, we require functions, right? So, we'll take function, let f of x and g of x be two functions, okay, such that whose limit is exist. We are considering two functions whose limit is already exist whenever x is tends to a. So, we'll consider limit x tends to a of f of x is equals to L, okay, and limit x tends to a g of x is equals to F. Okay, now therefore the first algebra is limit x tends to a of f of x plus g of x. That means addition of two functions. So if you have addition of two functions, then the limit can be spread over the addition. So this will be equals to limit x tends to a of f of x plus limit x tends to a of g of x. Okay, you can take this limit inside the bracket, you can spread over the addition. So we already know that the limit of the function f of x is L and the answer of this is M. Okay, same algebra over the subtraction. That means you can also spread limit over the subtraction. If you have, instead of addition, if you have subtraction sign, then f of x minus g of x, then the limit of that will become limit of f of x minus limit of g of x. That means So this will be equals to L minus M. Okay. Now the third algebra is over multiplication. Okay. So I'm just replacing sign. So if you have a two function and the multiplication of function f of x and g of x, so yes, you can also spread limit over multiplication. So here the answer will be L into M, right? And the last one is, not last one, scalar multiplication. That means if you have a limit x tends to a, k times f of x, then you can take k outside because k is a constant. So it will be k times limit x tends to a of f of x. Okay, that means it will be k into limit of f of x is l. Similarly, you can spread limit over the TVJ. F of x divided by g of x. So this will be equals to limit of f of x divided by limit of g of x, which is equals to L upon M. But the here condition is M should not be equals to 0. Okay, so these are five algebra: subtraction, addition, multiplication, scalar multiplication and the division. Now we have some standard function and we will see the limit over that standard function. So here we can take this as a note. Limit of x tends to a of any constant will remain constant. So if you apply limit over any constant, so that value of constant remains same. Second one is limit of x tends to a over the x. So if you substitute x as a, you will get the value a. Okay. Now the third, limit x tends to a of x raised to n, answer will be a raised to n. You can directly substitute the value of a. Then limit x tends to a root x r is equals to rth root of a. And the last one, limit x tends to a of p of x, it is equals to p of a, where px is a polynomial. Okay, so that means if you have polynomial in x, then limit of that polynomial will be p of a instead of x. You can substitute a. Okay, now we will see some example based on this. So in next class, we will see example.